Hi everyone, welcome to this class. Today we are going to talk about what is syntax. In fact, syntax is a branch of linguistics like phonology, morphology, and semantics. Syntax deals with how words are put together to form phrases, how phrases are joined to form clauses, and how clauses form sentences. Syntax enables speakers and writers to compose complex messages in order to communicate effectively, either in the native language or the foreign language. Heads and modifiers. Those terms refer to two very fundamental topics in syntax in order to do syntactic analysis. The head and its modifiers. The head is the key word in a phrase. It's the word that carries the most meaning. The head, in fact, controls all other words in a phrase. Modifiers provide additional information to the head words. For instance, we can have noun head words, we can have verb head words, preposition head words, and so on. Here we have some examples of noun phrases in which the word house is the head and all other words are the modifiers. So we have houses, the head alone, it can happen in sentences and in clauses. These old houses. Here we have a determiner this as a modifier and an adjective old. The houses in my town. Here houses is modified by a prepositional phrase in my town. Modifiers can be of two classes, complements and adjuncts. Complements are mandatory. It means they are necessary for the meaning of the phrase, to complete the meaning of the phrase. Adjuncts are optional. Adjuncts generally provide extra information and they can be omitted of a phrase without altering the meaning of it. Look at the example. Mark bought a car for you yesterday. Here, what is the complement? A car. Because if we say Mark bought, simply the meaning is incomplete. But if we say Mark bought a car, the meaning is complete. For you yesterday are both adjuncts because they are not necessary for the basic meaning of the phrase. Heads and modifiers build different types of phrases. For example, noun phrases, the large house, adjectival phrases, very sad, prepositional phrase, in the garden, verb phrase, work hard. All of them have a main word which functions as the head. For instance, in the verb phrase, work is the head and the adverbial hard is the modifier. Now, we know what's a phrase. A phrase is a head word plus its modifiers. Phrases build clauses. A phrase is just a unit of meaning which enables speakers to refer to persons, things, actions, events, places, times, and any other situation. A clause, on the other hand, is a more complex structure. It is formed basically by two constituents, a noun phrase which functions as a subject and a verb phrase which functions as a predicate. Here, it is important to talk about internal syntax and external syntax. Internal syntax refers to the structure of the clause And the external syntax refers to the function the elements in a clause perform. Constituent structure must be seen as a larger structure necessary to do syntactic analysis. It is the way words form larger structures having meaning. Because if a structure is just a string of words without meaning, it's not a grammatical structure, neither a syntactic structure. A constituent is the basic structure in a clause. It can be a single word or a string of words expressing meaning. For instance, the Ecuadorian tropical forest has a rich variety of animals. Here you can see that the noun phrase is the Ecuadorian tropical forest, where the head word is forest. All of the other elements are modifiers. And following the head word, we have a verb phrase, has a rich variety of animals. Here, the head word of the verb phrase is the verbal form has. In order to recognize phrases, we have some elements, some rules that help us to know what type of phrase it is. Phrases are known as constituents, and they can be moved from one position in the clause to another without changing the meaning of the clause. In this case, we have transposition. Look at the examples. Last Sunday, comma, I went to the church. Here, we are going to move the constituent last Sunday, which is functioning as an adverbial of time. And we can say, I went to the church last Sunday. We change from initial position to ending or final position. A second way to recognize phrases is called substitution. Substitution shows that a single word can substitute for a string of words hanging together as a constituent, always functioning as a constituent. Be careful with this. Look at the example. We put the books on the desk. Now we are going to substitute on the desk for the word, for the adverbial, there. And we say, we put the books there. But the meaning is the same. A fair rule to recognize that a string of words is a phrase, it is ellipsis. As you know, ellipsis deletes the second occurrence of the same constituent when two clauses are joined by the conjunction end. Look at the examples. My dog killed a rat. My dog ate the rat. We have two clauses. Now we are going to omit the noun phrase, my dog, in the second occurrence, in the second clause, and we will join with and. And we say, my dog killed a rat and ate it. And we avoid the unuseful repetition of the same terms. Here we have completed lesson 1. God bless you. Thank you.